Welcome to Almost Here, Around the Corner Future Technology Podcast with Richard Jacobs. Future technologies poised to transform our lives for better or worse are the focus of this podcast. Almost here means these technologies are now here and starting to be used, or just around the corner, from Bitcoin to artificial intelligence, 3D printing, blockchain, virtual reality, and more. Coming to Dallas, Texas, September 14th, 15th, and 16th, 2018, the Blockchain and Future Tech Expo. This is going to be a gigantic conference of over 5,000 people. We're going to be talking about blockchain and its applications. We're going to be talking about quantum computing, cybersecurity, artificial intelligence, and several other future technologies that are poised to and actually changing our lives as we speak. Here's why you should attend. As you may know, early adopters are the ones that investigated and profited from things like the gold rush in the 1800s, from the dot-com boom in the 1990s, from the internet boom in 2005, from the smartphone explosion in 2007, from the real estate boom that ended in 2008, and of course, from the Bitcoin boom that started in 2012. Early adopters act now. They don't wait till later. They go out west first in their covered wagons. They find the biggest gold nuggets. If you consider yourself an early adopter and you want to find the biggest nuggets, then you owe it to yourself to attend this upcoming conference. Blockchain is going to affect how we control and store our medical data, how we send money around the world, how we bank, and more. But artificial intelligence, quantum computing, and cybersecurity will play a pivotal role in our lives as well. And that's why our next event, September 14th to the 16th at the Dallas Convention Center, is going to have not only 5,000 plus attendees, but we'll showcase blockchain, AI, cybersecurity, quantum computing, and more. You want to get in on the coming gold rush of future tech and opportunity as an early adopter. Don't be left out. To register, go to bftexpo.com. That's blockchainfuturetechexpo.com. Thank you.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Future Tech Podcast. Mine and the host, Juliette Lamar. And on the line today, we have Lane Mendelson. He is the president at VantagePoint Software. Hello, Lane. Welcome.
Hi, Juliette. Thank you very much.
Thanks so much for joining us today. I'm really excited to hear about your AI system. Can you go ahead and tell us about VantagePoint, what you guys do?
Sure. Yeah. So our company was founded in 1979 by my father, Louis Mendelson, and he decided to start the company because as an individual trader and investor, if you think back to the late 70s, there was not a lot of tools or information for people trying to navigate the financial markets. In fact, most people didn't have computers, so they were using handheld calculators or, you know, actually plotting their charts by hand with a ruler and a number two pencil on graph paper. And so my dad has always been a visionary and always been into technology, and he started to see kind of the way that things were moving in the direction of the personal computer. And he thought, gosh, if there was a way to meld technology with the financial markets, that would be a home run, and he would be able to really have a competitive advantage over other traders and investors. And so he started developing software back when almost no one had computers. And it really gave him a tremendous advantage, and he just got really passionate about developing technology, refining it, and utilizing it for his own needs, but also then providing it to others looking for that same edge. And I came into the business as a little kid just because at the time my father's company was located on our family ranch just outside of Tampa. So I'd come home from school, I'd go sit in the office, listen to calls, talk to the employees, and just through osmosis, I got bit by the bug, got really excited about everything, and now it's been over 20 years that I've been working full-time in the company, developing the artificial intelligence software, the VantagePoint software, and involved in really all aspects of the business.
You know, it is so rare to find a tech company that has been around for this long, and nonetheless in the same family, so bravo.
Yeah. It's either you have to have a passion for it, and you have to have a real dedication and commitment to it because, well, in any business, you know, there are going to be ups, there are going to be downs, there are going to be challenges, and it really just requires perseverance, and it's easy to persevere if you really are excited and passionate about what you're doing.
And I can hear it in your voice, you know, the passion is behind it. And you guys at your company have a lot of core values, and that's probably why you have sustained for so long.
Oh, yeah. Very, very important. The core values are what define us, and we live by those every day. It's part of the training when someone joins the company. We have quarterly meetings where we talk about the core values and what they mean. In fact, my 7-year-old daughter came to our quarterly meeting that we had last Friday, and I called her up, and she knew all the core values, and it was just – for me, it was exciting because I know she had been practicing the core values, and she wants nothing more than to be a part of the company. She's seen what I've been able to do and how much I love the business and the relationship I have with my father, and I think even at 7, she sees that and she wants that for herself.
And you must be so proud about that because, you know, even at 7, she can see your strength, your passion, your dedication, and there's no other flattery than your children wanting to be like you. You know you're doing something right.
Yeah. Well, next year will be our 40th year anniversary, and if I do a good job in terms of continuing to develop the technology, service our customers, provide world-class support, and my daughter has the ability, which she does, to come into the office and see what's happening and just be exposed to it all, I really believe that it will become what's now a second-generation family-owned and operated company, will then be a third generation. I mean, this company could be, you know, a 100-year-old AI technology company down the road, and I'm really counting on my daughters to get that exposure, get that passion, and come into the business like I did.
Exactly, and can you imagine what a 100-year run of a company, what kind of knowledge and rich history you would have? So tell me a little bit about, I guess, how you've seen the industry change with AI over this long span of time.
Well, you know, originally, my dad, when he was developing the software in the early 80s, he wasn't utilizing artificial intelligence. What happened was around 1987, big, you know, crash in the stock market, October of 87, it was a real eye-opener for my dad because what he realized was that the stock market here in the U.S. didn't just crash for no reason, and it didn't crash just because of what was happening here in the U.S. It was really a domino effect. The markets in Asia tumbled. That affected the markets in Europe, which affected the markets here in the U.S. And so he took a step back. He said, wait a second. This is a global event that just occurred. And he saw that this was the beginning of a true global economy that was developing. And so what he did is he said, gosh, you know, if you want to be successful in a global economy, you have to have a global approach. Well, traders and investors typically back then and even still today, they look at charts. So if they're trading Apple, they'll look at a chart of Apple. If they're trading Netflix, they'll look at a chart of Netflix. And they're looking at stocks in isolation without regard for how that particular stock will be impacted and influenced by other stocks and other markets and commodity prices and even things outside of the United States. And so my dad realized you have to take this global view to analyzing stocks, and that posed a problem because how can a human being analyze individual stocks that they want to trade in, but then analyze other markets and other stocks that drive and impact that stock, both domestically in the U.S. and internationally overseas. And so that's where he started looking at different technologies and mathematical approaches to analyzing massive quantities of data. And that's what led him to artificial intelligence, is that he found out that artificial intelligence is a way to analyze massive quantities of data, organize it, make sense of it, and then use it to generate an output that can be utilized by an individual trader, a human being. And so this was back in the late 1980s, and then VantagePoint, our software that was our flagship product, has been out for over 25 years now, helping traders and investors navigate the markets with 86% accuracy. We launched that in 1991. So we have a long history of software development for the financial markets, specifically focused on utilizing and implementing the power of artificial intelligence. And I don't know of another company in our space that's been doing it that long. And our efforts are ongoing. In fact, we've just ramped up our research and development team so we can do even more research and make even more headway for our customers and helping them become more successful.
That's excellent. I mean, you're really staying ahead and on top of the ball here, because everything is changing. There's getting more and more information, and you're able, because of your years of experience, to see those trends, to see problems before they happen almost. So
yeah,
tell us a little bit. You have several different technologies and things that you offer at VantagePoint. You want to go through those and let us know a little insight into each?
Yeah, I mean, everything that we provide is designed to empower the individual trader so that if someone has been working and they've been saving money and they're starting to trade or invest and they want to grow it to a point where they can retire, we're going to give them the tools, the information, the guidance that they need to be successful where most people are not successful. The other thing that we're doing is we're helping people who've already reached that point of retirement. Now they're living on a fixed income and they want to obviously protect their hard-earned money because they're not generating more of it from working, and they want to make it grow. So all of the tools and all of the indicators and information that's built into VantagePoint is designed so that, you know, look, I have a high school diploma. I never went to college. But, you know, if you are motivated and dedicated and intelligent and you have the right tools, you can accomplish anything in this world. Well, we've done that for people who don't have PhDs in math or aren't economists or didn't go to school to learn about finance per se. We're giving them a shortcut to be able to get to that point of success and consistently succeed because they're relying on information that has been scientifically proven to work. And so the tools and the information that we provide it's customizable. If you're a newer trader, there are different approaches and strategies that you can utilize the software for to fit your needs as a newer trader. If you're more experienced or even an expert at the financial markets, well, then there are other indicators and other strategies within the software that you can implement. And so as somebody grows, both in terms of their knowledge base, but also their success, you know, as you have more money available to you, your risk propensity changes, your approach changes, and the software will adapt and evolve with you along the way. And that's really powerful and I know really useful to a lot of our customers.
Oh, absolutely. And, you know, hearing in your voice and also seeing your website, how human you make all of it, you know, technology can be so isolating for people thinking that, you know, the machine is smarter or, you know, it's going to take away jobs or the robots are taking over the world. You put such a humanistic twist to everything that it's working alongside of us, not as us or for us. It's kind of a tool that you can just use with you.
Yeah, I mean, artificial intelligence in general, it will replace jobs. It will take jobs away. But the types of jobs that it will take away are things that really don't require a human to be involved, things that are mundane or repetitive, which will then free those people up to do other tasks in the world that are not mundane, that are not repetitive, and could not be automated and do require a human being. So it's really shifting from, instead of having a human being do something that a human doesn't need to do, it's freeing people up to do things that humans do need to do. And in this case, what the software is doing is it's VantagePoint's analyzing all this global market data that we as humans couldn't analyze. It's providing information that's 86% accurate and basically serving up that on a silver platter to the trader, and then they can look at it and say, okay, well, now that I know what the price of Apple's going to do over the next 3 days with 86% accuracy, what do I want to do? And it just makes it really easy for the individual trader to make the right decision at the right time. And so really it's decision support information that we're providing to people, but you know, they still get to use their common sense. They still get to use the education or knowledge that they've gathered or obtained over the years, and that just empowers us as traders and investors and allows us to think. But when we're making our decisions, it's based on information that will help point us in the right direction, like I said, with 86% accuracy, and that increases our confidence levels, and it obviously increases our success levels.
And I was talking with someone else about AI and in the workplace, and I was thinking it would also create more of a work-life balance for people because you free up this time and the trader says, okay, I know what Apple's going to do with 80% accuracy. Maybe I'll go out and see my kid's baseball game, or maybe I'll go home early tonight and see my friends. So it could also, if you look at it in that sense, with the computer's working for you, it could create a better work-life balance as well.
Oh, absolutely. You know, our software VantagePoint is end of day, which means it updates each evening after 6:30 p.m. Eastern. So during the day, there's nothing that you need to do, nothing you need to look at. You come home, you know, have dinner with the family, watch some TV, relax, And then you go, you update the software, and within 10, 15 minutes, it's going to give you information that will help you manage any open positions or trades that you are engaged in. So maybe it's like, okay, this trend is coming to an end. Looks like it's probably time to take profits, or this trend's going to continue, so let it ride. So it will allow you to manage those positions and then alert you to new opportunities that are starting to present themselves so that you can position yourself so that you're not chasing the train down the tracks. That's the big thing. It's all about timing, allowing you to better time your entries, better time your exits, but without requiring you to sit there and, you know, analyze graphs and data and numbers, you know, 8 hours a day, because most people don't want that. And interestingly, Juliet, the people who do that, we have people who contact us all the time. Hey, I'm sitting in front of my screen all day long. I'm making some money, but boy, this is not the life I wanted. Funny thing is, if you're sitting there all day long, you're in and you're out, and you're in and out, you can make money doing that, but you're, number one, it's not a good work-life balance, as you mentioned. The other thing is, all you're really doing is catching little bits and pieces of the trend. And so what our approach does is it allows customers to identify a trend, enter that trade when the trend is first developing, not after the fact, but when it's first developing, ride that trend in its entirety, and then when our software analyzes the data and says, okay, this trend is coming to an end, then that's when you can take your profits and get out. So instead of riding every little up and down and up and down, you're riding the overall trend, capturing those profits, and then exiting that position. And it takes less time. You know, from our perspective, it's less risky, and ultimately, one could be more profitable.
And less stressful.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So I know there's a couple other companies out there who are using AI in this similar manner. What really sets you and your company apart, besides your 38 years of experience, which in my mind is already huge? Do you have little extra things that your customers use that is unique about your software?
Yeah, here's the thing, and you know, more companies now are starting to pop up and tout, you know, artificial intelligence. In some cases, I think they're just kind of putting that in their marketing material because it's a buzzword for many people and many companies.
Mm-hmm.
And so there really isn't any AI that's happening, but it looks good on websites and marketing brochures.
Mm-hmm.
But there are some other companies that are starting to use AI, but here's the difference. And I'll give you an example. Let's say you're using Siri or you're using Alexa. Technically, that's artificial intelligence. It's voice recognition, and it's going out, and maybe you say, what's the weather going to be like tomorrow? And it goes and it finds the weather for tomorrow. Well, it is using AI, but it's a very simplistic form of AI. You know, if you're using AI to analyze one person's voice pattern, that doesn't change. You know, so once it learns it, okay, it's got it. Whereas the financial markets, they're constantly changing. So we use a very advanced form of artificial intelligence called neural networks, which is machine learning and deep learning, which is analyzing data, looking for patterns and relationships in that data to draw conclusions from, which is how we forecast. But those relationships in that data, it's not static. It's constantly changing. And that's the big advantage, is that our software is able to mine that data and be aware of changes in that data, and that's what's called retraining the neural networks. It's constantly learning. But when you look at artificial intelligence like Alexa or Siri, things like that, it's really not performing a task that you couldn't perform on your own. I could go look up the weather myself manually. I don't need Alexa to tell me the weather, but it saves us some time. It's more of a convenience, whereas the artificial intelligence that we're utilizing and the way that we're utilizing it, it's not doing something for us that we could do on our own. It's doing something that's humanly impossible to do, and that is analyzing those massive quantities of data for us so that we can make intelligent decisions. And I'll give you an example. When I say massive quantities of data, here's what I mean, Juliet. Let's say someone's trading Apple, and I use Apple just because everyone's familiar with the company and what they do. If you're trading Apple, there are so many other factors that drive, impact, and influence the price of Apple. So, for example, other technology companies have to be analyzed. Currency prices have to be analyzed. There are a lot of different commodity prices like precious metals, interest rates, stock indices like the Dow and the NASDAQ, the S&P, but also Apple's a global company, so you have to be looking at other stock indices in other countries, because it is a global company. We are in a global economy. And so now you've got all these different factors, and we're analyzing each day what did each one of those markets and stocks, what was the open price, what was the high of the day, the low of the day, the closing price, the volume, how many shares traded. So you add all that up, now you're talking thousands and thousands of pieces of data. there's no way a human could analyze that and benefit from it.
Yeah, I mean, that's humanly impossible. And why this is such important software if you want to be competitive in this market in this day and age?
It's an absolute requirement. It's not optional. And that's what my dad realized back in the late 80s. He realized this is coming, and you've got two choices. You either adapt and profit because of the global economy that's developing, or you bury your head in the sand, you pretend like the world isn't changing, you keep doing what you've always done, and there's no such thing as static. There's no such thing as standing still. You're either moving forward or you're going backwards. So the people that have not adapted their trading approach for the global economy that we're in, they're still looking at charts and using technical indicators that people were using 20, 30, 40 years ago, and we're living in a different world. And the markets are operating differently. And so those are the people who are, you know, kind of, you know, pulling the hair out of their head saying, what's going on? How come this isn't working for me? And it's because they haven't adapted their strategy and their approach for the changing world that we live in.
Exactly. And I think when you put it in that way, people are slow to adapt typically because of fear of the unknown and whatnot. And really, when you come across a company like yours that is laying it out on the table in such an understandable manner, I think it's easier for people to make that leap, make that jump.
Yeah. Oh, and you said something earlier about really how we humanize it. And that's because we are family owned and operated. And we really care about our customers. We're not some large organization that treats our employees as a number or our customers as a number. We realize that for all of us to be successful, then all of us have to succeed individually. And that means, you know, everyone on our team, our customers. And we just approach everything from that perspective. And we do a lot of things. For example, we have spent a lot of time and money, not just on developing the AI technology itself, but developing the user interface of the software so that if someone's 85 years old and they have not really had a lot of experience on the computer, they can still benefit from the predictions that come from VantagePoint. And that takes a lot of work. It's very easy to take something that's really complex and present it in a very complex way. That's easy. What's really difficult is taking something that's really complex and simplifying it down and making it digestible by literally anyone. And that's what we've really worked hard to do and have succeeded at doing. And that's what's allowed our company to be so successful, not just from the perspective of revenues and growth, but we've been able to do so much outside of the company walls. I mean, we've partnered with Shriners Hospitals for Children last year. Just last weekend at our seminar here in Tampa, we have a seminar twice a year for our customers to come for 3 days and really learn new approaches, new strategies, and become even more successful. Well, I gave a $10,000 check donation to the Shriners Hospitals for Children, and that is because each week we're making a financial commitment to our Shriners partnership. And as our company experiences success, we're giving back to the community and not just changing the lives of our customers and not just changing the lives of our employees, but also changing the lives of those in the community. And that's a great thing for us to do. And I'm doing that not only to help the Shriners Hospitals for Children, but I'm also doing it to hopefully influence other companies and other entrepreneurs to follow suit and give back as well.
Absolutely. Speaking of the future and moving towards that, you know, I also see in here that you're getting involved with cryptocurrencies. What kind of services do you offer for clients who are interested in jumping into that realm of things?
So what we've done is we have adapted our artificial intelligence technology within VantagePoint to forecast for the cryptocurrencies. So it looks the same. It works the same. We've had customers who said, look, I've been trading stocks for 5 years, 10 years, 50 years, whatever it is. What's this crypto thing? How does it work? And interestingly, you know, you don't have to be an expert in cryptocurrencies to be successful in cryptocurrencies. And you don't have to be an expert in commodities or currencies or anything else. You need to know not so much about it, but what it's going to do ahead of time. So we've adapted our technology for forecasting what the price of Apple is going to do in the next, you know, 2-3 days. We can forecast what the price of oil is going to do in the next 2-3 days. We can forecast what the price of Bitcoin or Ethereum is going to do in the next 2-3 days. I will tell you that a lot of people might think that cryptocurrency pricing and values are random or erratic. They are predictable. There are patterns. And the reason why I know that is because we have been able to now successfully predict for the cryptocurrencies. And the way that we're doing that is, again, not just at, by looking at Bitcoin in isolation, but by looking at what other factors, and this is something we have a patent on, what other factors affect Bitcoin. So we have a patented process that mines the data and says, if I want to forecast for Bitcoin, I need to first identify what are the factors that influence Bitcoin. And that's a patented process. Then once we identify what forces and other markets affect Bitcoin, then we say, all right, now let's start figuring out how it will affect Bitcoin. And then we're able to generate the prediction. And Bitcoin is being influenced by the stock market, by the price of gold, other currencies, both crypto-related and actual physical currencies like the euro and the dollar and the yen and so on. And the challenge that we had forecasting for cryptocurrencies as opposed to like forecasting Apple or Netflix or things of that nature is they're so new. So if we wanted to forecast for a stock like Apple, well, we can go back and we can get 10 years of data. Well, mm-hmm. if you want to forecast for the price of Ethereum, Bitcoin, or Ripple, there isn't 10 years of data to analyze. And so we had to adapt our technology to be able to predict at a high level of accuracy, even though it didn't have as much data to go back and pore over and analyze through the machine learning processes to use that information to forecast. So it was a bit challenging. But and we can't forecast for every cryptocurrency. There's only a handful that we have been able to achieve a high level of accuracy. I mean, anyone can predict anything. The question is, can you do it accurately and consistently? And so we've narrowed it down to just the stocks, just the currencies, just the commodities that, yes, we can achieve somewhere between that 80% accuracy rate. And if it's much lower than that, it's not something we offer to our customers. And truthfully, not something they should probably be involved with.
Well, absolutely. You hold yourselves and the world around you to a higher standard, which in turn makes everyone's life better.
Yeah, because it's not about quantity. It's not how many stocks mm-hmm. can I trade. It's about quality. I'd rather trade less stocks, a small handful, very successfully, versus say, yeah, I trade, 1,000 stocks and haven't really achieved success. So, yeah, by narrowing it down, and we've got scanning features in the software that will really just pinpoint those profitable trading opportunities for our customers. Yeah, if we can narrow it down and make it easier, it's like shooting fish in a barrel, and that is another factor that allows our customers to be even more successful.
Absolutely. So, I mean, what's on the horizon for you as a company, as for VantagePoint? Do you have some stuff in the works you'd like to share?
Yeah, we actually are working on adding a couple of more cryptocurrencies to the VantagePoint software package, and we're going to be releasing very soon the cannabis stock forecasting features in the software.
Mm.
So that's something we've been working on. We don't just, pump something out just because we think we can sell it. It's got to meet those very high standards. It's got to be tested, retested. It's got to be proven, and it's got to be consistently accurate. And so we're just about at the point where we are going to be able to offer to our customers the ability to now forecast for the cannabis stocks. And that was a challenge also because not all of those cannabis stocks have been around a long time. A lot of them are newer, so again, we were working with smaller amounts of data and still able to achieve high levels of predictive accuracy. And some of those cannabis stocks are listed on the U.S. stock exchanges, other on the Canadian stock exchanges. And so we were able to acquire that Canadian stock data and feed that into the artificial intelligence for it to mine that data and look for those hidden patterns and relationships, which allow it to then forecast. So we're pretty excited about that. And we've had a lot of customers who've been asking for that. And we're very excited about being able to make that available to them soon.
Absolutely. I just want to share one little thing from your website. I love this. 24,927 lives changed since 1991. That really is, you're counting the people that you're changing their lives. It's not just, oh, I hope they use our software. I hope they're doing good. You're in it. You know whose lives you've changed. You know whose lives you're involved in. I just love that.
Yeah, well, I'll give you an example. At the seminar this weekend, we had customers from all over the country that came to spend time with us, learn more, gain more confidence, become more successful, learn strategies that maybe they weren't ready for then, but they're ready for now. And there was one woman in particular, and we don't have a lot of customers who are women, but we had five women customers at this event, so that was really awesome. But one of the women, she said, Lane, I've been a customer of you guys for 12 years. And it was just so nice for me to, you know, meet her. I had never met her. She has never come to one of our events. But she said, I use the software every day. I'm just about at the point where I'm ready to retire from my full-time job and make trading my full-time source of income. But then she said, but I don't have to do it full-time. I have many other hobbies and interests that I'm now going to be able to participate in, but I'm going to literally replace my full-time income from my job with my trading profits. And she said, you know, it's taken me time to build up that confidence to be able to walk away, because she has a pretty high-paying job at a prestigious company. But she's now gotten to that point where she feels comfortable being able to continue to provide for her family, but now not have to work full-time. And so she said, hey, this has really changed my life. And, you know, to me, that's priceless to hear that. I loved hearing that. And I heard that from so many people that were there.
That's fantastic. That truly helps you continue to do good work when you get that kind of feedback.
Absolutely.
Well, Lane, tell us a little bit about the best way for people to get in touch with you.
The best way to get in touch with us is go to our website. It's VantagePointSoftware.com. And you can read about the software. You can see videos of the software. I think the best thing is to fill out a form that allows you to get a free live demonstration. We'll actually personalize it for you, show you exactly what the software does, how, you know, if someone says, look, I'm newer to the markets, we can show you how to use the software as a more novice investor. If you're very experienced, we can personalize it, customize it for that type of an individual. And, you know, picture's worth a thousand words. So the best thing to do is get a live demonstration of it and then see exactly how it will help you gain that confidence, become more competent, and ultimately more successful, so that we can have yet another success story.
That's fantastic. Well, Lane, thank you so much for joining us today on Future Tech Podcast. I mean, this has been very eye-opening and really just a heartwarming interview, because we know there's people out there doing good work, which is always nice to hear.
Absolutely. Well, thank you very much, Juliet.
All right. That was Lane Mendelson from VantagePoint Software. He is the president of that company. Check them out on VantagePointSoftware.com. This has been Juliet Lamar with Future Tech Podcast. Thank you so much for joining in.
Coming to Dallas, Texas, September 14th, 15th, and 16th, 2018, the Blockchain and Future Tech Expo. This is going to be a gigantic conference of over 5,000 people. We're going to be talking about blockchain and its applications. We're going to be talking about quantum computing, cybersecurity, artificial intelligence, and several other future technologies that are poised to and actually changing our lives as we speak. Here's why you should attend. As you may know, early adopters are the ones that investigated and profited from things like the gold rush in the 1800s, from the dot-com boom in the 1990s, from the internet boom in 2005, from the smartphone explosion in 2007, from the real estate boom that ended in 2008, and of course, from the Bitcoin boom that started in 2012. Early adopters act now. They don't wait till later. They go out west first in their covered wagons. They find the biggest gold nuggets. If you consider yourself an early adopter and you want to find the biggest nuggets, then you owe it to yourself to attend this upcoming conference. Blockchain is going to affect how we control and store our medical data, how we send money around the world, how we bank, and more. But artificial intelligence, quantum computing, and cybersecurity will play a pivotal role in our lives as well. And that's why our next event, September 14th to the 16th at the Dallas Convention Center, is going to have not only 5,000 plus attendees, but will showcase blockchain, AI, cybersecurity, quantum computing, and more. You want to get in on the coming gold rush of future tech and opportunity as an early adopter. Don't be left out. To register, go to bftexpo.com. That's blockchainfuturetechexpo.com. Thank you. You have been listening to Almost Here, Around the Corner Future Technology Podcast with Richard Jacobs. Subscribe to this podcast, post a review, to discover more future technologies that are poised to transform our lives for better or worse, such as Bitcoin, artificial intelligence, 3D printing, blockchain, virtual reality, and more.